We are at Lake Rebecca in northern Hennepin County for the muskie spawn. Our office every year spawns the muskie for the entire state, usually when the water temps are between 50 and 60 degrees.
When the water's 48 degrees, approaching 50, then we will set nets around the shoreline of the lake, and we've got 16 nets out here today, and they're trap nets. And so the fish instinctively swim into it and can't find their way out, and then we collect them safe and sound.
We check the traps every morning and unload the fish and then bring them back to the beach to separate the males and females for spawning.
You know, it's beautiful on a lot of days that we're out here spawning fish, but on a lot of days, like today, it's snowing, and some days it's super windy, and some days it's stormy. But when fish want to spawn, we have to be ready to collect them. The weather's been tough this spring, and so our catch rates haven't been quite what we were hoping for. Today we caught two males and one female that didn't have any eggs to give us.
That is not giving up.
So I don't know.
Non-productive female.
No clip, right clip.
Right clip. Dang. We didn't get lucky with the fish eggs, but maybe that'll happen tomorrow. So we've just collected these muskies and we're gonna check their pit tag number and then see if their males are females and if they're in spawning condition. Yesterday we don't catch any females that have eggs to produce, and then today we were lucky enough to get one female that had eggs.
Oh, there's eggs!
For each year that we're stocking, all the fish from that 1 year class will get one of their pelvic fins clip, or they'll have no fin clip. It's a quick and easy way to tell if the fish is a brother and sister. And in that case, we wouldn't want to spawn them together.
So our quota from Lake Rebecca is 700,000 eggs every year.
Every year we handle about 50 to 70 muskies, and we collect eggs from 14 females. We're squeezing down the body of the fish and we're looking at the vent area of the fish to see if eggs do come out and how freely they flow.
When we get the males, we use a siphon to collect the sperm. We collect the sperm, we do three males and then mix those with one female. And that produces one lot of eggs.
Just going to distribute the sperm over the eggs. Now we're going to add water to activate the sperm.
They have about a minute to find an egg to fertilize the egg.
Each lot of eggs from this year averaged about 35,000 eggs per female.
Now that we have our fertilized eggs, we're going to take them to the St. Paul Hatchery.
They've already gotten the eggs from the field, and now they are bringing them to me at the hatchery. So the first thing that I have to do when the eggs get in is I need to drain all of the old water, and then I put them into an iodine bath. This iodine bath, they set in for about 10 minutes, and that is what sanitizes the eggs, disinfects them from whatever was out in the field. After they've been in the iodine bath, I give them a little rinse, and then we have to measure them. I need to know how many, what the volume of the eggs is as they come in, because that volume is one half of the calculation that I need for calculating exactly how many eggs I get. But then once we have the volume, I go and I put them onto a rack. We call this rack a battery, and they sit in a little jar on the battery, and that is where the eggs will incubate until they hatch.
And there we go.
After they hatch, they usually take about 7 to 10 days to get to the next step. So during those 7 to 10 days, the muskie are feeding off of their yolk sac. It's what is giving them nutrition during those first 7 to 10 days of life. And once they've absorbed that yolk sac, they swim to the top. They are ready to start wild eating. They are fed when they're in the hatchery on a 24-hour clock, currently every 5 minutes all day.
because if we don't give them food basically at any opportunity they feel like they want it, they will make their own food. And that is their brothers and sisters. And so we have to feed them, you know, full day and night cycle to minimize that as much as we can. We raise the fish until they are about 2.5 inches in size. That's kind of like a really small, what we call a fingerling. So we increase their size by about 55 to 60 fold before they go out the door, and that takes us about 6 weeks.